percent. What Africa is buying worldwide. Our next markets for Africa, we have divided Africa as explained into four different areas. The east part of Africa, the west part of Africa, the near south and the very down the south. Mm-hmm. South Africa of course is dominant by South Africa itself, so it's very challenging to enter this market. But the market that is very close to us and we are able to enter there, and there's a lot of opportunities for the Egyptian sector industry, is the eastern part of Africa. Mm-hmm. And again, eastern part of Africa is very important because these are the countries surrounding the Nile. So again, it has a political direction that we have to be there in these countries. So that's what, as Exponent, we are facing, focusing now to take the Egyptian industry, whatever it's the wood industry, it's the building material, it's the pharmaceutical, it's the textile, it's the engineering sector, to take these countries and go there to the eastern part of Africa.
Right, sir. We all know that Egypt has excelled in the field of manufacturing furniture during since thousands of years ago. We've all seen Egyptian craftsmen with the manufacturing the old Mashrabeya style. It's known in history that the Ottoman Empire used to take Egyptian craftsmen to Istanbul for their talent. How can we benefit from this talent Egyptians have?
Following your lead on this, definitely we have a rich culture of furniture manufacturing, and it has been enhanced with the many history that passed through Egypt, like from English the British occupation or the French occupation. This has all enhanced many skills in Egyptian labor. And following your lead also regarding design, we have enhanced our design capabilities throughout the last 9 years, from bringing international designers to this very rich cultures. When we have designers coming from Europe, they always complain that things are extremely mature in Europe and they don't have any more inspirations. They come here to get inspired by the culture.
Yeah.
There's a lot more to do in design. We still have the excellent craftsmanship, and we are enhancing it every day through trainings, like Khaled said, through technology.
How can we revive the old style, the antique style of furniture? How can we revive the Mashrabeya style? And this can be used in export. I think it's very admirable.
It's already revived, and there's already the benefit now is that there are specialized people working in every field, in Mashrabeya field, in old French classics, in old English classics. I'd like to invite you to come take a look at the current exhibition, because you will be amazed with the designs and quality and the ethnic touch that is available in some of the items that enriches the Egyptian culture.
Yeah.
It's quite interesting. I think you should really come visit. I'd like to invite everyone to come visit.
Right. Going back to your history and culture and the building in which you have been talking about your particular institution or companies investing or maybe expanding the Egyptian industry to eastern part of Africa. Well, if you go back to the 50s and 60s, at the time the Nile of the Nile in particular was taking part that phase, there was solidarity with South Africa, and maybe that what created that that solid relationship with the that part, so countries in the part of South Africa. And maybe when the relations deteriorated, things deteriorated with it also, and we can take that Nile Dam, the Renaissance Dam, as a very perfect example. Now, there was some suggestions that we could revive those relations again and take the steps of people like China, like Israel, like, for example, Japan, like Italy. They're investing very good, and they are dominating the market in South Africa, and they're also establishing good relations with those countries there. So does that evoke any ideas to the people to be able to not do this again and try to build ties?
Definitely Africa, when we talk about now in the international market, Africa is the most undeveloped market yet. Mm-hmm. On a it's not only us, it's the whole world. Everybody is going to Africa. There's a huge opportunities for development is still ahead.
Exactly.
So of course, we are considered Africans because we are in the African markets. And like you said, in the early 50s, we were there, we were present, we were there through the Nasser company that was, sorry to mention the name, but that was part of our strategy at that time. So definitely, that's why we said as Export Association, and when we saw especially the number that only 0.5% of the world exports to Africa, it's only the Egyptian part, and it should be more than that. We can even go six-folds, and that's without even affecting the competition. So to go to Africa, we have to have a strategy. We cannot just go directly to this without any plan. So the plan is that, like I said earlier, we start with East Africa, following then the Western part of Africa, because Western part of Africa is a huge ocean development, and because of the Ebola over there now, we are a little bit resistant to go right now until this is overcome. If you talk about East Africa, there is a huge potential for the engineering sector, the home appliances, the white goods, because in Egypt there is a lot of good production in the engineering sector, whether it's refrigerators, ovens, call it washing machine, there is a lot of need for that part. Come to talk about the building as well, there's a lot of development happening in the development of the real estate over there in Africa, in South of Sudan, in Congo, in Rwanda, in Rwanda.
South of Sudan, some Egyptian companies.
They're already present over there. But our start is going to be from Uganda, followed then with Kenya. Uganda is still a closed country because there's no seaside for it, but it's still serving Rwanda, it's serving Congo, it's serving Burundi, it's serving South of Sudan. So the trade of these countries are being done from Uganda. And then another plan is going to Kenya. Kenya, where we're going to be serving to Ethiopia and Tanzania. And these two countries are buying their goods from Nairobi, the center of the city, the capital of Kenya. So that's the two sectors where we're going to take 120 companies, Egyptian manufacturers, to go and market their products there in this region. Having a success story that will be developed in the eastern part, we will follow with another mission that will go to the western part of Africa. We have Angola that has a huge growth. We have Nigeria, in spite of the risk of already in the business. We have Mozambique. So these countries are yet being developed and with huge opportunities. We are of course faced with the competition from China. We are faced with the competition from India. We are faced from Turkey. But yet we have an edge over all these countries because of the COMESA agreement. The COMESA agreement gives us an edge of being examined from the customs, which is about 25%. The Egyptian government is helping the industry people with giving them 10% for their exports as a support to their exports. So that means you have an edge of about 30% over the competition, in which you can create your own market based on the products that is required there. So definitely we have a huge potential of growth. We just need to follow our strategy and focus and have the countries, because everybody was not looking at Africa, they were looking at Europe, they were looking at America, they were looking at Asia, they were looking at the Gulf, the Middle East, nobody was looking at Africa. This is where we should put our direction now.
Right, so how can we preserve the old form of art, and how can we raise the awareness of the new generations in Egypt and the awareness of all Egyptians to the importance of this classical and the traditional form of Egyptian art, like maybe, as I said before, the Mashrabeya style, and how can this contribute to our exports abroad?
We are definitely working with many societies and many universities in Egypt to make sure that such types of arts are preserved. We give special attention and special care during fairs, and we give special sections such cultural industries inside our exhibitions and fairs. We try to promote them to international fairs.